Our Shelby Clark spoke with the co-op pharmacy about some hot weather safety tips.
Joining us today is Michelle Teasdale, the pharmacy manager for co-op. How are you today?
I'm good.
So my first question has to do with the heat warning in effect. What should residents do to stay safe from heat illness?
Yeah, so we're definitely finally getting some beautiful summer weather, but with that does come risk for heat illness. Best thing to do, a few things you can do. Number one, avoiding the heat during the hottest part of the day. So between 11 in the morning and 4 in the afternoon would be the hottest part. So if you can be indoors, that's the best and safest place to be. If you are having to be outside working, best thing would be just to take frequent breaks in the shade and make sure to stay very hydrated. Some other things you can do to help reduce risk, again, that hydration is important. Also wearing sunscreen and staying covered, wide brim hats, sunglasses, and light colored clothing to stay covered up.
And can you tell us some signs and symptoms for people to know if they are experiencing a heat illness?
Right, so there's a very wide range of symptoms from very mild to very severe for heat illness. Generally, we'll start with a bit of headache, nausea, sometimes dizziness, and that's kind of the first sign that you are experiencing heat illness. And then more severe symptoms may be confusion and even passing out.
And if people do find themselves experiencing heat illness, what are some recommendations that you would give to help with that?
So for mild heat illness, the best thing to do is to get out of the heat. So finding a shady area or inside in the air conditioning to get cooled down. Lots of fluids, really important to keep the fluids up, either with water or even sports drinks to rehydrate. If some symptoms continue or become quite severe, then it's really important to seek medical attention.
And during this heat wave, what would you suggest is best which SPF to use for sunscreen?
So for sunscreen, there's lots of options out there. Most important is you find something that's broad spectrum, so it has UVA and UVB protection with it. Usually we say SPF of 30 or greater to make sure that you are getting protection, and then it needs to be reapplied every 2 to 4 hours, or if swimming or heavy sweating happens that might wash off that sunscreen, you want to keep repeating applications.
And for some residents that have no AC in their homes, what would be the best solution that you would recommend for them to do, especially during the plus to 29, 30 degree weather?
So I think it's just any way to stay cool. Sometimes cold compresses can help. Wetting the body down, kind of sponge bathing and blowing a fan on, that can cool the body quite well. It's really just trying to stay as cool as possible and then keeping the fluids up. Hydration is really, really important when it comes to heat illness.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much, Michelle, for joining us and giving us your time.
Thank you.
Some good tips to use against this heat wave.
Thank you.